All right, y'all.
Hi.
Hello. I wasn't ready. All right, y'all. Welcome, all my viewers out there. The live studio audience, clap it up, clap it up.
Clap it up, clap it up, clap it up, clap it up.
Give yourself some a round of applause, beautiful Blaqq people.
Yeah. Welcome to Let's Pop Off.
Let's Pop Off.
Yeah. We get to ask the back.
We are live from PS Social in Wynwood, Miami. Shouts to PS Social.
Shouts
out.
We
here. And we just had an amazing happy hour before we went live. So shouts to Opulent Event and Catering.
Word.
That fed us all.
That's why I can't sit right.
Yeah, we're trying to hide the food for the body now.
Trying to have this fed stomach.
That ceviche was A1.
I hope all of you had a lollipop off.
Oh,
courage juice, so that you guys could talk a little bit more freer. And our star bartenders,
Star tenders.
I don't really drink.
You got it right, star tenders. You got it right.
Star tenders. Shouts to PS Social for the star tenders. Shouts to our DJ Shorty Doo-Wop that had us vibing before we went live.
Okay.
Our photographer JR Photo, who's capturing all of us looking cute and stuff, because we all look cute. So in the meantime, I just want to introduce my co-host. Well,
what?
First, wait. Oh. Wait, I didn't even introduce myself. Hey, guys. I'm your girl, Supa Cindy, and Let's Pop Off is my talk show. We going to talk tonight and
you
pop
better
off.
Tell them.
But let me introduce you to my amazing co-host. First up, my girl, Bugatti Blaqq.
You already know what it is. It's your girl, Bugatti Blaqq. You busting me, I'm busting back.
Talk to me twice.
Next up, we got my girl Taylor.
What's up? It's your girl Taylor Haley from the BK, now in the MIA.
Hello, Dominica.
And last but definitely not least,
talk to him.
We have Big Will.
Come on, man. You already know what it is. Not the two. But the one. Big Wizzle, for real. Holla at me, man. Talk.
So let me explain what Let's Pop Off is. Let's Pop Off is an interactive talk show. When I say interactive, all of you people in the audience, there will be a mic in front of your face and you can pop off on whatever topic we're talking about.
Yeah.
And also all of you at home, my girl Taylor, she'll be talking to y'all in a minute. She's going to, you know, the social media platforms.
Get your Twitter fingers ready.
Yes, and pop off, because we want to hear what you have to say as well. So We ready to pop off.
Come on,
we're ready to go.
I'm ready to pop off.
All right. So we're going to kick off the show with a segment I call, You Know What I Just Realized. So should I go first?
You should go first.
The queen always goes first.
You know what I just realized? I'm doing something wrong. Because I saw that Sexy Red has a new lip gloss line, right?
Oh, here we go.
And can I just tell you what the lip glosses are?
Come on. Okay. Tell us.
They may actually be really glossy.
No way.
The lip glosses are called Coochie Juice.
Wow.
I mean,
Booty Hole Brown.
Ew. Wow.
Nut.
Ew.
Wow.
Why am I like that?
Yellow Discharge, my favorite.
Ew.
Gonorrhea.
Never.
And Sex on My Period.
Maybe.
Sometimes.
So you know why I say I'm doing something wrong? Because she's going to sell out of these lip glosses.
Of
you know that, right?
Yeah. And watch it be real high quality, real shiny. That period, Sex on My Period, might be a ruby red. Watch.
You think it's going to be ruby red?
It's going to be a nice.
It should
like
be bloody red.
That too.
I was just over here looking like, this. I'm looking crazy. Like, what the?
We going to kiss a girl?
Would you kiss? Would you kiss a girl if she said, hold on, let me put my gonorrhea on?
Hell no, we gold. I got to find a way to get up. I got to go. I got to go.
You have to know the name?
No, I don't.
It's the consistency of the product.
We don't care. We never care.
All right, who else wants to go? You know what I just realized? Bugatti?
You know what I just realized? Mm-hmm. That I like men like me for 4 weeks, and then they leave me. That's
What's
it.
That all
like
about?
A 4 week. It's a 4 week dating period with me. I don't know what it is.
It's a 90-day trial.
Like a four, is that 90 days? Yeah, that's like 30.
I mean, that's like
if
a receipt.
If I get 90, I might fall in love with a nigga. I don't know. You know, that 30-day period kind of be blowing me. Like the first week, we all good. Second week, it kind of slow down, especially if I give them some. Third week, it be kind of like making you rethink things. The fourth week, I'm kind of like, might want to commit suicide. I don't know. What's going on? Like, I thought we was making and building things, you know? So, yeah, I just realized I might just be a 4 week shorty.
And how long does the honeymoon stage last, though?
With like
the
four a week women? And a half, 2 weeks.
That's a good week and a half,
right? Be the best. Ooh, yes. That's why I be telling my friends, like, I think I love them. They be like, girl, slow down.
Girl, I love you.
It's just been 2 weeks. It's okay.
Girl, I love him.
I did.
And now y'all he in the group chat like,
I don't mention him no more.
DNA, you don't put tombstones on his
they
name.
They know
the
when
phone.
I stop talking about a nigga. They be like, yeah, he gone. Damn.
R.I.P.
So, Taylor, what did you just realize?
I just realized that McDonald's be really giving you one sauce for a 10-piece nugget and then have the nerve to want to charge you 50 cents for a next
or
sauce.
Extra.
Like, girl, I like to dip, bite, and then dip again. And then if I'm real hungry, I like to dip my fries,
French
too.
Fries.
Like, what am I doing with DM dipping. Sauce? And that's not coming at your paycheck. Did you give me just throw a little salt.
They do
on
act
the
like
side.
It's coming out their paycheck.
And don't
though.
Even talk about the one napkin. That's what really
the one girl. Napkin and then the paper straws really blow minds. Cause if I'm ordering a large drink, don't give me no damn paper straw. Cause now I'm like and I can't even finish my damn drink. I'm pissed.
Well, I can't wait to hear what you gotta say.
Why you can't wait to see what I gotta say?
Come on, baby.
Cause you're the only man.
You know what I just realized? I'm about to get my ass cooked up here, boy. Hey, but never women in here. Hey, look, listen, before we start, I didn't do it, but I apologize early. Cause I already see how y'all looking. Y'all look good, by the way. Y'all look gorgeous. So look, I'm on y'all side tonight. Look, whatever y'all say, I agree.
Just nah.
I'm looking around. It's only like 3-4 guys. They got their head low. He eat his little chicken over there. He ain't trying to. I know they don't want no problems, but I'm in front of the camera. Please, ladies, listen.
Take it
y'all
easy on Big
y'all
Bill.
Gorgeous. I didn't do it. It was I wasn't with them. I wasn't with them guys. So please take it easy on me. Okay, can we agree on that?
It wasn't him.
Oh, damn, everybody asked. I'm dead. Yeah. Nobody, and they just looking. Oh, I'm dead.
So you
we got
sitting
you,
on
Will.
The counter.
We got your back.
Shoot. So you banging on that sofa.
It wasn't me.
It wasn't. I didn't
the
do
remix.
It.
The remix,
right?
For real. For real.
Well, that was the segment. You know what I just realized? And it was sponsored by Rockstar Wireless, where all rock stars stay dialed in. Go to rockstarwireless.com and sign up for the unlimited talk, text, and data for as low as $19.99 a month.
Ooh. Go ahead now.
I like that. Rockstar in my life. So let's talk about this.
Let's go.
One of my homegirls in media, she interviewed the goddess, Mary J. Blige.
Ooh,
right?
I love MJB.
And in case some of you don't know, when you're about to interview somebody, sometimes the artists say do's and don'ts. I won't talk about this. I don't want to do that. I don't want to do this. So one of the things that were on the list, I'm not saying Mary said it. Maybe it was the record label. I don't know who it was. We didn't clarify that part. But she did not want to be called auntie in her interview. Like, don't call her Auntie Mary, all right? So, okay. At what age do you start, is it okay to call somebody Auntie?
Let the
when you
answer.
Are Auntie in real life, when you got somebody calling you Auntie, you are an Auntie. Wear it with pride. But there's different tiers to Auntie.
Come on now.
Now, explain, you got.
Explain it.
Come you on. Got the spiritual Auntie that always want to tell you, like, you got to move within the Lord's spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Then you got the rich Auntie. That just be like, this is peasantry.
Mm-hmm.
Then you got the turn up auntie, the one that won't tell your mama stuff. Mm-hmm. And that's the auntie you really want to be with. And then you got the auntie that's like, oh, girl, you my aunt? Okay, that you don't got no respect for.
Mm-hmm.
Certain levels of women have certain auntie features. Like you too, like Mary is an auntie because she wear auntie boots.
Those ain't no auntie boots.
She wear auntie boots.
Come on.
Shots fired at the boots.
People on those socials. Am I lying? Am I flying? Mary don't wear them auntie boots. She wear them cute, but that's her auntie boots.
Mary wear them hoe boots. I don't know what you talking about.
That ain't no auntie boots. And that's a fly-ass auntie boot.
That ain't no auntie boots, baby. I like to knock the boots. Where is y'all? I don't know what you talking about.
You saw them Givenchy boots. Those auntie boots. Them Givenchy gold ones. Who wearing gold boots? Nobody but an auntie.
No.
Well, you know what? Why don't you go see what's up in your station?
On social media.
See what's up.
Okay.
Thank you, right, Will.
What's
what
up?
Are you talking about?
Oh, I thought.
What about aunties?
Auntie, I want to hear what you got to say about the auntie.
Listen, before I start, you're all beautiful, okay? You're gorgeous.
Here you
go. But if your birthday year has 1900, earlier, later than 93, your auntie. 93 or down, your auntie.
I declare.
So say it again.
If your birth year is 1900, 93, on down to 72, 62, your auntie.
I'm an
Kiss my ass.
Hold on, listen, let me tell you something. If Juvenile back that tail up, play, and you run to the crowd,
you're an auntie.
Come on, that's true. Listen, if your prom picture looked like that prom picture, you an auntie. You know what I'm talking about. It was on Polaroid. It told you who you made it, what year it was made. You're an auntie. So listen, it's okay. I'm an unk. Look, I'm dressed like an unk. I got my little polo.
You definitely dressed like an unk, man.
So you an auntie?
I'm an unk. I said I'm
an
unk.
You're an uncle?
It's okay. I live long enough.
Well, that's because you've embraced your unkness.
Listen.
There's some women out here. We ain't embracing that shit. Don't want to hear that.
It's hard, isn't it? But it's
not hard.
Hi, auntie.
Wait. We're going to come to you.
He's going to come.
Clap
it up one time.
There's nothing wrong with being an auntie. It's okay.
The socials say, well, they say, you're not an unk, you an OG.
They ain't gonna talk to him. Listen.
They say, you are.
I'm comfortable. It's now, okay. See, I live long enough.
All right, so wait. Let's see. Before you come pop on. Off with the audience, Bugatti, what are your?
I would prefer the OG status. Like, I like OG versus unk and auntie. You unk me, that's like really like how you just dated me. I don't want to be dated. Nobody, no food wants to be dated. No person wants to be dated. I don't give a damn who you are. Don't call me your auntie. First of all, we ain't even related. How about that?
It's the beauty in it. That means they respect and love for you.
Ain't no beauty
in it. What auntie? You have knowledge to them. You inspire them. They vibe with you.
That's not
embrace
auntie.
Embrace the auntie. It's okay.
They call me your
You're
mama
gorgeous.
Then.
Love you.
Okay.
What's happening? Talk to me.
Well, I feel the opposite about the auntie comment because I get called auntie every day. But I think it's a matter of respect. So I think they was coming at Mary J. Blige maybe out of respect, like calling her auntie as in somebody you look up to. Like, I don't have any kids, but I'm everybody's auntie. And I know all the secrets, you know, I'm the cool one, stuff they won't tell their mom, they're gonna tell auntie. So I think auntie is kind of like saying in so many words, like, I mess with you, like, you know, in other words, like, I have respect for you.
It's better than ma'am.
And I can't call you grandma or ma'am. Or ma'am or miss. I think the new thing is like saying sus. It's auntie. So I kind of embrace the auntie word. So I look at it like respect.
What you think, Supa?
So it's crazy because you just said ma'am, right? You know, I interviewed AB, Antonio Brown, the infamous. And the entire interview, he called me ma'am. I thought I was going to jump in the floor and just bury myself.
No way. I think that kind of ages you.
For real.
Yeah, I don't ma'am me, but you can auntie me all day.
Well, the thing
is this.
I'm
okay with being auntie.
I'm Latina, so all my nieces and nephews, they don't call me auntie. They call me tia. So I'm not used to the auntie word. I don't play that.
Can I ask you a question, though?
And, yes.
What is tia?
Tia means auntie.
Oh, okay. Talk to me.
But it's the IE for me. It makes it older. I don't
it
like
dates it.
It. But I was at a parade in Liberty City, right? All these little kids were like, Supa Cini, Supa Cini. And one little kid came up to me, Auntie, Supa. And I was just more, I just don't like the auntie. I'm not with it.
Just call
like
me by
it.
My name.
It just doesn't make me feel good, and I don't like it.
It sounds better in Spanish when they say it, huh?
I don't like the auntie. Don't call me auntie.
Cindy, on the socials, they say auntie is usually the fun with who has no kids or care in the world. That's the auntie that people like being around. That's what most
that's
people
her.
Say.
That's
well, I have no kids, and I'm living my best life. Okay, I'll take the
auntie.
Exactly.
You better take it. It's okay. I love it. Embrace it, ladies. Yeah. Embrace it.
I think it also depends on who it's coming from, right? And the direction that is coming in, because some people can use it negatively, right? Like, yeah, what's up, auntie? Like, excuse me, young lady.
don't do that.
You know what I mean? Because I don't even know you like that. So I also think that it comes from the relationship too.
But I'm not even gonna lie. When that kid called me auntie, and it just like sucker punch. I was like,
you haven't heard it before,
auntie?
Huh?
The person that I was with, one of my coworkers, was like, nah, Soup. It's that they love you. Like, their mom listens to you all the time. They love you. That's why they're calling you auntie. And I was like, I don't like it. I don't like auntie. So I get what Mary J. Blige's people are saying.
Nah.
I don't know.
Did Mary
get
mad? Did she express herself at all in that?
I didn't get to interview her, unfortunately.
Oh, okay.
But the girl didn't call her auntie because it was on the list. But she was wondering, what's the big deal? Everybody calls Mary J. Blige auntie because she's the auntie in a good way. I don't want to be called auntie. So if you see me out there, don't be damn.
She like, what up? Don't call me auntie.
That's a hell, call me no auntie.
That's a hell of a thing to put in your rider. Do not call me auntie. Like,
call her tia. She be, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
That'll
so
work,
thanks
right?
for popping off, audience. No, tia. Yeah, tia.
But
tia
means my aunt.
You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
All right, so let's keep the goings going on. This segment is called Survey Says What?
What?
Here we go.
All right, so let's see what this survey says. A survey for the last 15 years asked 2.5 million adults in the United States, how would they rate their current life? Now, the survey found that married people consistently reported their happiness higher than unmarried people. Why? Isn't true? Are married
why
people happier
why,
Will, than
why
us?
You looking at me?
I don't know, because you're married.
But you're married, though. That's why I look.
I all I saw was Will, I cut to the left. Why you looking at me?
She the married one.
Damn, yeah, I even say nothing. Wow, that's tough.
So you guys think that married people are happier?
Let the married person answer.
I'm happy as hell. That's why I'm like, show it. Gave me this.
Show it.
Bra.
That's why I got one of these.
I'm happy as hell. Somebody chose me. We've been together 14 years. I've been married 9 months now.
Oh, I can still. Okay. Mm-hmm. My bad. Let me go and slide on. Let me go to T.I. over here.
But she sometimes, I feel like it's subjective. I feel like that people who are unmarried, sometimes y'all be having a little fun, but then y'all be caught up on a man too much, or a person, or a partner, whichever they, them, she, her out there. Y'all be like, I need somebody. You don't need nobody but a pack of batteries and have a great time.
Pack of batteries.
All you need is an electronic boyfriend and have a great time.
That's y'all problem now. That's
have
why.
A great time. We you don't need down. No man
don't
for happiness.
Don't invest in Duracell anymore.
No, you don't. No.
Sponsor Duracell. Alone. It keeps going and going and going.
I feel otherwise. I've been on both sides. I've been married, and now I'm single. I'm living my best life. Listen, when I was married, I mean, he was a great father, whatever, but it was just like, okay, get up, go to work, take the kids to school, come back home, cook, clean, go to sleep. Tomorrow, get up. I was like, I was not living. I was not living. Great, lasted 10 years, but now I'm outside, baby.
We better talk all right? about
so it. So I feel like single people, because we could do whatever we want, wake up whenever we want. I don't gotta share my bed, my closet, my nothing. Ain't nobody telling me what time you coming home. None of that. Like I really feel free, and I'm real happy.
Aw, y'all clap it up for the single people, man.
Should you be home at a certain time?
When you're married.
That's what I'm saying. If you're married, like that's not a crime to ask you.
I'm too free.
You too free for that? She like I'm too free, papi. I come home when I want.
I love
She's
that.
She's like I love it. Who else ready to pop off? Let me
you,
see.
You know what? I was gonna say you can find someone else who wants to pop off about it. The married single thing. But, like, my whole thing is this. Like, when you're married, you're damned if you do, damned if you don't. Because when you're not single, you go through rough times, and you're like, why did I even commit, bro? Like, I'm sick of this. Like, when you're in the honeymoon stage, you're on cloud nine, you want to be booed up all day. As soon as that honeymoon stage crashes and it's not a honeymoon stage anymore, you no longer want to be in a relationship. So I'm currently single, and I'm honestly dating myself right now, like I'm dead ass dating myself. I sound like a lonely auntie.
She don't got no cats. She don't have no cats. I promise she don't got no cats.
I have a bird. Hi, music. But I think like if you're gonna be in a relationship and be so freaking miserable, that's how people feel. And nowadays, when you meet someone, the minute you say, oh my God, I have a flat tire, or I'm not feeling well, or you say something that's not going right for you, they're out. They don't want to invest no time into knowing anything about your personal life if it's in a negative state. And before, when people dated, if you say, oh my God, my tire is flat, babe, where are you? I'm going to come, where you at? Now, damn, that's your favorite. Where you
for
at?
For sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cindy. Where's Will? Pop off.
That's
I'm
true.
Right here. The bartenders say they got to pop
off. Behind the bar.
They say they've been popping off all night, so they say they want to pop
sure.
off too. They say they want to take what they want to take.
Our star tender. Yo, what's
star
up?
Star tender, ready? Well, don't y'all maybe come back here now. He's over. I know we ain't done. Talk to me.
All right, so look, I heard the girl over here in the corner. She mentioned, damned if you do, damned if you don't. Damn you right. Damn, you right. And you know what? I don't look like it, but I swear to God, I've been married and divorced, and I've been offered probably too many times and keep saying hell no for a reason.
Oh, you've been asked to be
for
married twice?
They
told me to push it closer.
Wait.
You... Oh, okay, my bad. Let me get up here with you.
Yeah, get that little talk.
So, yeah, no. I'm going to stay divorced.
Wait.
And I'm probably going to get married again.
She said she'll stay divorced. You've been asked to be married twice?
I've been asked to be married three times.
Three times. And why did you say no?
You want the truth or you want
the
lie?
I want the truth.
Okay, one of them got locked up. One of them got locked up, so I was still his fiance.
He got locked up.
The other one, I couldn't do it. It's called a headache. Okay. And then I actually married my second boyfriend, who was 18 years my senior. But that was for...
All three
I'll
of them.
Go say
hold on, hold on,
good
hold on.
Lord.
That's right.
All three of them had red flags. I don't even know. Red,
hold
orange.
On. Hold on now. Because if he didn't go to jail, she would have married him. So it wasn't ever off the table. She just said he got locked up.
But.
I'm just saying.
The jail thing didn't just pop up like we popping off. That was, he got that in him. It ain't on him.
They
want to
know what
him.
You did with.
That ain't something that just popped up. He just automatically. I went to jail today just off of GP. No, you are a criminal. You have a history. You like to do things that are go beyond the law. That's a red flag. Number two, 18 years your senior. He has no business being with you in the first place, because when he was 18, you were one. And then the third one, that's the one that you said that he gave you a headache. So if he gave you a headache, baby, that means that he was not for you, wasn't evenly yoked. That was not the one for you. So you know what? Three times a show. That's why you're single. You're absolutely
she,
right. You shouldn't have said yes.
Striked out.
Shouldn't have said yes.
She say stay single.
Stay single till you get it right.
Till you get it right. I don't know. Okay, that's
chewy.
Pop off.
Next.
Who was pop off?
Oh, she got her hand up. Let me talk
to
her.
We got more popping off in the front too. We love the audience to get involved.
Talk to me.
Well, I'm an auntie. Me.
Girl, you a young auntie.
Never been married, but I'm living the best life I can possible right now. Like, these men don't have nothing on me. I am the prize, the present, the gold, the buzzer, the dog, everything.
Ooh.
It don't get no better than this, baby. So when you get, I don't want to be married. Sorry.
Okay.
Wow.
She said what she said. What she said. She said what she said.
Ooh.
Can I ask her a question?
Hold on. Here we go. We got somebody who's married, right? Talk
okay.
So who's standing up for the married people?
Let's go.
You.
Hey,
girl.
I've been married 10 years, although I look 18, but
yes, you should.
17 years, yes, it's a lot of BS involved, but I made the commitment, and I'm sticking with it.
Exactly. Sometimes we want to kill them, and sometimes we love them.
Sex. We have fun.
We have sex.
And Joe.
I hope y'all
we're
having
definitely
sex.
Equally yoked. Yep, yep.
Okay,
yep.
That part.
Together.
That part.
Oneness.
Exactly. I love that. She made a mention of being evenly yoked. A lot of y'all, we don't even understand what that even
means. You were going to ask her something.
See what
were
mean?
You saying?
See what I see, fellas? See how I got set up?
I was going to ask her something, which was probably gonna turn
going
to turn us around.
Down to
I was going to ask her, why does she think she's the prize and not the man? Because, you know, there was something out there where the man was talking about. No, seriously. They were talking about. Well, the woman actually mentioned it. She was like, I feel like men are the prize because men do the choosing. Men have to ask you to marry them. Men have to ask you to be their girlfriend.
Oh,
men
no.
have to.
No.
Men are the.
No.
Listen, don't shoot me.
No.
I ain't the bitch that said it.
Absolutely.
What's going on?
Electric chair. Absolutely not. Electric chair.
Now,
electric chair.
All the guys chair. Back there throwing hand signs, but they ain't saying nothing.
But in defense of her, men have to believe that they are the prize as well. You don't want a man out here thinking that he is less than you. You want a man that believes that he is a prize as well. I don't believe that you should just be the one in the relationship being a prize. You should have a man that's a prize as well.
I'm sorry. I have to disagree with that.
Uh-oh.
Thank
here
you.
We go.
In the relationship, I'm the damn prize and you sit your ass down. Period. Because when the men feel like they're the prize, that's when ego, edging God out, comes into play.
Okay.
And they start acting brand new and thinking they're cute with their holes in their socks.
Uh-huh.
And
not the hole in the
sock. You. I'm like, excuse you, I'm the prize, not you. Sit down.
Exactly.
Period.
That might be immaturity, too.
It is.
You want a mature man who understands what he can bring to the table and who understands what you bring to the table. And he values what you bring to the table. But at the same time, he doesn't dumb himself down in order to let you be who you are. It's
damn.
About being evenly yoked.
Damn,
that's where evenly
Bugatti, who you just described, he sound fine as hell.
Right?
I've been looking for him for 4 weeks. I ain't found him yet.
Shorty, where he at?
Well, first of all, I do think that we are the prize, but I am a strong believer in you do need a man in your life, as far as me speaking personally, for whatever reason you want to use him for. It might not
whatever
be.
His purpose.
Because, yes, I think he serves a purpose. I don't play with toys, and I think that I need a man to feel his body and all of those things. Okay. But yeah, I'm not a child. I don't play with toys.
But I feel like
no toys over here.
Wow, also what? Looking on the socials, they saying
wait,
that
let's outside on social.
Socials say outside's getting old real quick.
Hello.
But then I have somebody saying here on our Instagrams, why we just can't both be the prize?
I just said that.
But what does that consist of? When you say you're the prize and I'm the prize, if we bring in something to, if I'm bringing steak and you bring in filet mignon, who bring in the appetizers? Because I need to know that when this goes left or right, we 50-50. That you can't be out here thinking one is better than the other or you contributing one thing that I can't. Because at the end of the day, like you said, you the man is the one who usually asks you to marry him. But I got the right to say hell no.
That's true.
And you may be the one to do buy the ring and do it. But I have the choice to be like, this ain't it. And you got to go.
Yeah, you definitely
So you wait until he asked you to leave? Why you been leave?
Oh, no, I'm going to leave. One thing I'm going to do. I got a daddy who loved me. He said, I can go home. I'm out of here.
Because I'm like, if y'all got that far, I'd be that
yeah,
far.
I don't think that you should be that far where he's asking you to marry him and right? Now you're deciding to leave.
Because
you didn't know you wanted to leave a long time ago.
We see it all the time on the internet. Them girls who do the guys do the proposals and the girls say no and now they all mad. They have a right to tell you no.
Yeah, but see, he been
saying. Do you not think why he mad? You ever wondered why is he mad? He probably was really invested, and then we get to the door, and you tell me, no, the one we did all this shit for, I could have been left.
Because maybe I just want to have fun with you.
And
I
she probably
for 9 years, nigga, how much fun?
And she probably didn't even communicate it effectively
so why you
either.
For now?
Because women swear they the best communicators, but we really suck at it sometimes. Like, we really horrible at communicating. So he probably didn't even know she had a problem with him because we like to stomp our feet, suck our teeth, and roll our eyes and think a man's supposed to understand what that means. Baby, speak. Talk to me. Tell me what's going on.
Tell me what
Point
it is.
Point me in the direction of what I did wrong so I can correct it instead of you acting like I can read your mind because a man can't, just like a woman can't.
And we wait 9 years and then you're going to tell me, hell nah, at the door, like, come on, man, seriously, what we doing? We too old to not know how, do not know how to date. Absolutely. We old enough to know how to date now. You know what you like. It don't take long. I don't like you. I'm gone. It's okay. You know, we wasn't cool.
You know what? Honestly, like I always
At
said.
At this point,
that
I don't know how to date.
You know.
Okay. We got to get Will last time because.
Yeah, I'll come back. Go ahead. Talk to me, Cindy. Talk to me.
I was going to say that. I forgot what I was going to say. No, I was going to say I'm joking. I was going to say that. I always said that if a guy were to propose to me, like with cameras and a big deal and whatever, even if I, tell me if I'm wrong, even if I didn't want to at that moment, I would just say yes to not embarrass
him. Oh, no, you're dead ass
destroy
wrong.
Him.
I'm sorry.
And then when we go home.
Let her finish. Let her finish. Let her finish, guys.
Absolutely not.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Oh, my God. They're popping off.
Let her talk. Well, Cindy,
wait, let me finish. You guys ain't even letting me finish. Like,
let her finish, guys.
Can I finish my sentence, please?
Let her get it out.
So what I was saying was no, but honestly, because I would be thinking of him that I didn't want to destroy his soul and embarrass him, and it goes viral. But then when we're in the car, we're going home, I'll be like, Frank, you know, honestly, I just named
Frank.
Him Frank. I don't know who the hell Frank is. I'm going to be like, honestly, I'm not ready to get married, but I didn't want to embarrass you, but I still care about you.
Oh, my God. Cindy.
That's how is that wrong?
Yes. He going to turn the wheel and just take y'all both off the highway, say stuff like that.
Hey. I'm not embarrassing
him. He just going to turn the wheel.
You dangerous? You dangerous?
What are you like? How am I dangerous? I'm thinking about his heart.
But then you're going to get in the car.
Wait a minute. You guys got to pop off on the mic.
Listen.
I need you to pop off on the mic. Instead of popping off with each other, pop off on the mic, please.
She done took two shots.
Who wants to pop off?
She ready to pop off.
Like,
she
so
took two
will.
Shots, so she
what
ready.
What are y'all two talking about right here?
Bartender, can you come up, though? Because
yeah,
behind
too.
The bartender, that's the bartender.
You two
tell
next.
Them how you feel.
Okay, so my name is Najee. I personally have never been married, and I don't really have a lot of people in my family are married, but I have like a lot of friends and aunts or whatever that are married. But I just think it's like you said, for example, I think you said you've been married for like 14 years and you just got married within the 9 months, right? Mm-hmm. For me, it's like I feel like, or just like you said, you are married and then some people said they're being divorced. Like my first boyfriend at 19 asked me to marry him. I've been asked to be engaged twice, but I know from the beginning when somebody is not my person. For example, like for you, the 14 years, I'm pretty sure your husband was showing you something to keep you there.
Sure was.
Or just like you said, you're bringing the steak, he was bringing the filet mignon, but who's bringing the appetizers? That's the thing. We want too much in the beginning. Like we want too much, and a lot of times we want something from a man that we can't even give ourselves. Woo! And somebody made a comment about the sex, and then it's like, okay, the sex could be good, but the size isn't good enough. Or he can stroke it good, but the way he eat it, it
you
ain't good enough.
You better read
all shit. Like everybody wants more, and it's like a lot of times, and with me, the reason I'm not in relationships is because I realize when you get in a relationship with people, you can either be that person that carry it, or you could be that person that's taking too much from it. And if it's not a healthy balance, I don't think it's gonna work. So single and married people both have something in common, and the thing that's in common is communication. If you want it, you're gonna get it. Because I bet you if you wanna be a millionaire, you're gonna work to be a millionaire.
Girl, you
so
better
if you
teach.
Want a man that's gonna be your man and your prize, you're gonna build that man to be your prize.
Hello.
Now y'all have a good day.
Preach, preacher.
Talk to him.
Preach,
and her
preacher.
Talk to him. Good. Drop the ball.
And pew, 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 pew.
And I'm drunk.
I was saying, and her drinks taste good, too.
I'm a little tipsy.
So do we think happy or single people are happier? Who's happy? Married or single people?
Who's happier?
Both.
It's the same thing.
Give her the mic. Give her the mic right here. And then I want to hear what the pink and the blue jean was talking about, too.
Honest and willing to tell the truth. Because okay. I think a lot of people that's single, they kind of embrace a single because that's just where they are. But they go home at night and they do want more. And I do believe that a lot of married couples stay in relationships also. Because sometimes they just trying to put on and they don't want to, you know, be the talk of, oh, they getting a divorce. And, oh, they seem so happy. So yeah. I think the matter is whichever status you are, just being honest, keep it real and just say what it is. That way the next person know. Because a single person could be surrounded by married couples that all of them cheat and none of them are a perfect example. So you have to surround yourself by examples and don't always be the strongest one in your clique.
That's good advice.
That way that you can always learn from the people around you. Because if everybody's on the same thing,
where you
going
to grow
from each other?
Exactly.
Same thing with a lot of guys. You have a lot of guys that's married, but they have so many single friends.
And don't hold
now
them accountable.
They have problems at home because they doing what the single friends do when that's not your place. You have to be an example and know who you're around so your friends can encourage you to do better.
That part.
But you know what honestly, like married and single, the whole thing with that is like when you're in the honeymoon stage, I just wish relationships could stay in a honeymoon stage. Because, like, nothing bothers you when you're in a honeymoon stage. He could burp, fart, your boss could be a jerk.
I want to smell it.
Nothing bothers you. You're like, oh, flowers, and I'm fluttering on the moon. But then as soon as things start getting rocky, everything annoys you about them. You don't want to be with them. And then you're like, damn, how do I? You know what I'm saying? Like it's just hard. You know what I'm saying? Whether you're single or married, like you guys said, marriage is hella work.
For sure.
Being single is hella work,
it
too.
Is.
To keep your mental health good so you're not depressed because you're single.
Because you got nobody to talk to at home. But yourself.
That part.
Because the
hell.
Dating pool nowadays is so difficult and dry. Like, it's hard.
But don't you think we did that to ourselves?
No.
We didn't do that to ourselves? Really, let's be honest here.
You said the pool is pissy.
We did this to ourselves.
The pool is
pissy. So we didn't do this to
ourselves?
Who been
peeing in the pool?
We don't like to be honest. We did this to ourselves.
Who, men?
Everybody.
Oh, okay.
Everybody did it. We added to it. Everybody added to it. But nobody really telling the truth. Being single sometimes sucks.
Yeah, that's true.
Especially when you get older, you don't really have nowhere to go. You just home.
Big
like, I used to go out. I used to be out here, but now it's like, damn. Now, who you supposed to talk to? Now you in the mirror line tell stuff, man, see, boy, now you still got it? Yeah. No, nigga, you ain't got it. You're home by yourself.
That sounds so horrible.
The socials is going up for Star-Tango.
I'm just saying.
That sounds so bad.
No, I see a lot of guys
who do
it. I hope
I'm not that single friend.
But when you look at their life, you're like, oh, you came to the picnic by yourself. No girl, nobody. Yeah. So you roll to the picnic by yourself, listen to Trick Daddy by yourself. By yourself at 40-something? Goddamn.
Whatever.
Wow.
But it's better to be by yourself than with trash. So hello. It works what both ways.
I love it.
The socials are saying we taking them to church, and they going up for our star attendance. They said this is a tabernacle of popping off. They said, yes, preach, preacher, preach, star tender. And
y'all popped
off. They said, you doing it facts, baby. It's a lot of snaps and claps.
Y'all popped off.
You did it, girl.
All right, so even though we were talking, oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Mama.
Oh, no, so I was going to say, to your point, regardless if you're single or in a couple, I think it's your security level in who you are as a person. Because I'm single, and I sit at home,
and I'm okay,
perfectly happy. I have everything I need at my house. Now, if I want to pop out, then I'm going to go out. But if I'm cool enough in myself that I can stay home. So when you have that level of security and when you can take that accountability,
that big word.
Also, to her point, be able to communicate what you need and what you like and what you don't like, that propels healthy relationships.
I love the fact that she used that word accountability.
All right, y'all.
No downside.
So we're going to go to the next thing because, oh, someone else had to pop off?
No, we're good.
All right, so let's go.
Back to you.
Even though this was kind of like in this category, but the next segment is called Relation Tricks.
Oh.
And this story like is touching nerve for a lot of people. This is about a single mom that I saw. She was online crying.
Oh, my God.
And she was just saying she has three kids with three different baby daddies. But don't judge her already. I didn't even
watch
know
it. Listen. Listen, don't do
and
that.
And she was just venting about the fact that she's not one of those annoying, nagging, bitter baby mamas. She's trying to work, raise her kids. But what she was talking about is the fact that because her baby daddies don't help her and aren't considerate with the scheduling part of being a parent, co-parenting, she can't really go get a better job because she's the one that has to pick them up, drop them off. So she's like, how can I upgrade my levels if I can't do that because my baby daddy is not willing to, well, one of my three baby daddies is not willing to help me out with the scheduling and everything. So I understand the daddies that are co-parenting with a bitter, mean, disgusting, you ain't gonna see your baby type of mom. But this woman honestly did not seem like that.
No, she didn't.
And it's real difficult. Like, I'm not a parent, so.
I'm a parent.
Yeah,
Bugatti, I'm a single parent. I was married before, and then I ended up having another baby. And my last child's father is nowhere to be found. Like, just gone. He in the wind somewhere. He out here. Y'all probably know him, but he out here. But
he a rapper? No,
he ain't no rapper. They thought he was. You know, I done been linked to so many niggas. But anyway, on some serious stuff. No, this young lady, it brought kind of tears to my eyes because I understand. She doesn't have a community. She doesn't have a village. She doesn't have anybody to help to support her. So she was looking for her children's fathers to step up. And she also mentioned, like, you know, I help y'all. You know, I bend over backwards to help you guys make y'all stuff happen. But when it's my turn, nobody's here to be found. And I think that just speaks to the immaturity and the lack of care and empathy that from the baby's father when it comes to that. It's almost like, well, you know, you got it. You strong. You can handle it. And I hate it when people say, you strong. You can make it. You got it. Yeah, I might be strong, but I need a little bit of help every now and again to make things work. You know what I mean? So it really sucks that she's going through that, and I totally get it because if you don't have a village, baby, you need a village.
Forget about it.
You need a village.
But you know what I'm thinking, and I don't know if this is going to switch up what we're talking about, but at what point do you say, I have two children with two different men, get on birth control or not have unprotected sex or whatever the case may be? Mm-hmm. Why do people just keep having more children than if their situation with baby number one and baby daddy number one was crap,
So you meet a guy, you're all in love. Oh, it's going to work out this time. It doesn't work. Right. Then you're going to meet somebody else for a third, fourth time and keep going. Like, I'm not in that position. I'm not saying anybody is, but why do they keep going? I just don't get that part. Like,
you got something to say?
I think that it's more societal pressure when that happens, because everybody tells you, oh, babies are a blessing. Well, if you're going to, you did the deed, you got to accept responsibility, and you, they guilt into parents to being parents sometimes. There's a page on TikTok called Regretful Parents where people write in stories, or parents write in anonymously of why they regret being parents. Brutally honest, straight up. It's a, look into it, it's really good. But they just say, like, most of the time they were promised a village, they were pressured into having kids, it was the right thing to do, the baby's this blessing thing, oh my God, you're damned to hell if you make another choice. Those things kind of alter the choice direction of being a parent. And when you have multiple partners, because if one don't work, you're like, okay, I'll try it again. Okay, then I'll try it again until you hit that one. Or they'll go, when you have your baby, your whole life is going to change. Yeah, and sometimes I may be damned to hell with this damn kid. Yeah. And now what? I can't shove it back up in there and get rid of it. I got to be like, all right, well, we're going to thug it out. And that's unfair to your child. That's unfair to the partner, because if they're not willing to be down on it, you just saying, well, I'm going to have this baby. Girl, yeah. Girl.
I think that also comes from our culture too. Like, and I'm gonna say it. A lot of us grew up in households with single women, right? So, and you raise a daughter, and she gets pregnant, and some of those mothers will say, "You good? You don't need no for nothing. Mm-hmm. You can have that baby. I'm gonna help you. You feel me? You got somebody to do X, Y, Z." But at the end of the day, mama really got her own life. But she done talked you into having a baby, because guess what? You independent. You strong. I did it. You could do it. But we're not built. We're not supposed to be built like that. We're supposed to be built under a two-parent family home. So to continue to have babies and babies on babies out of wedlock, it's really not good. You really should take a pause. Relax. Get on birth control. It's okay to get on birth control.
It's definitely breaking it down.
Yeah.
Sure is. On the socials here, somebody says, it takes a village, but you have to take accountability for your own actions.
Absolutely.
As well. You can't depend on other people to help you succeed.
There you go. Hey,
period.
We well, got some people got in the crowd that want to pop off.
Let's go.
All to them.
Okay, I have one daughter. I have one kid, and it's hard. Like,
I can't hear her.
Closer, mama. Put it
like, there you
okay,
go.
Like, sorry. I have one child, and I realize how hard it is, and I feel like it's hard to feel bad for you when you do it again and you know it's going to be hard. Mm-hmm. If you know your baby daddy family don't like to watch that baby, you need to make sure your next baby daddy family is going to watch the baby before you have it. Like,
I agree.
There's no excuse, and it's hard to feel bad for you because you made this decision. Like, I don't know.
So in the first, so wait, you gotta wait till they go to you.
Hey, girl.
So the first baby daddy, he's coming to you. So the first, when you have the kid with the first time, and you meet another guy, the first week you start dating. So
let
you
me
guys
meet
have
your
to
family.
Babysit.
That's gonna be the questions on the questionnaire for the baby daddy checklist. Do you like watching
your
kids?
Credit?
Can I drop family? It up to your mama house?
Let me meet your mama.
Hey, we finally got a fella.
Let's go.
Who's brave enough to say something? Woo! Here you go, brother. All praise be to you, brother.
I just want to say, I want to flip the script, what you were saying about the ladies having several babies. The thing that drives me crazy is, even though I'm a guy, when I see guys, particular guys, celebrities, you know who I'm talking about, who every single person got to have a child. That's crazy. Why do you have to consummate every single relationship
Blue
with
face.
A child? And next thing you know, you got dirt. 10, 12 kids, 12 baby mamas. They all live in different places. As siblings, like, they don't really know their family growing up, and then you don't have a father in the household, but maybe once a month. And it just creates the situation that we got going on now where, you know, kids reach out to gangs and other family and community. Like, we just need to cut that out. Just cut it out altogether.
No, it works both ways. I agree. It works both ways. I think men need to be more responsible where they spread their seed, and women need to be more responsible of whose seed they carry.
Mm. Oh, we got the hand raising over here.
The Yu-Gi-Oh cards.
Yeah, and guys be collecting baby mamas like trophies too. Like,
oh my God. It's the worst.
Go ahead, mama. Pop out.
Okay, so I've been a mother for 27 years. So I did it all on my own. However, I feel like it depended on me. You know, so I feel like a lot of women now have kids and be like, I need him, her, and everybody to help. But at the end of the day, it's really on us. My child, when you see them, you see me. You know, I'm very proud of the success because they are very successful now.
Shout outs to you.
I'm extremely happy and emotional. But it's a hard job, but it has to be done by the person who created it.
Yeah. Shout out to all the single moms out there doing the thing with your kids.
Don't worry, girl. It's going to be all right.
I know that's right, boo. You got right, this. Girl.
She look like she ready, boy.
You know, it's like for the past month, right, to keep it 100 with you guys, I've been like really focusing on launching this talk show, Let's Pop Off. It's been my dream for years. And the other day I was talking to my project manager and she has a daughter. And I was like, I just was talking to her and I couldn't even fathom adding a child and someone's life to be responsible for that in the equation of the madness that I've been going through for the last few weeks, months with this show.
Yeah.
So I don't know how you single moms or moms period are doing it, but I'm just hugging.
We got
how are you doing this? Like, it's unreal.
We love you.
I don't know how you're juggling it and doing it. Okay, mama, pop off.
So I'm gonna mess up the whole room. You remember we were talking about this guy that got locked up? And then you know how y'all are talking about all the people that don't have children?
You had one, didn't you?
No.
You got a baby with him.
But I got his kid.
Put the mic up.
You got his baby now?
I got the kid.
Okay. So you're like a stepmom.
No, I ain't with him.
Well, I mean, but you're the stepmother to the baby.
You're with his children.
I might as well be the mama, the daddy, and the pastor, too.
Okay, talk about it. Tell us.
Okay,
about.
So the reason why I brought this up is because I agree with you. You said that there's so many people in here, single moms. But honestly, I found it very easy not to get pregnant. It's called close your legs or take something for it. But I'm just saying. Yeah, dude, look, and pick your seed. Pick your seed. I can honestly say if I would have had a kid, he would have been a good one. We still friends. Mm-hmm. We still friends. But the kid is mine. The kid is mine.
I love that. I love that you stepped into that role like that.
Pop off.
Oh, right here. Right here. You ready?
Pop off, baby.
Talk it.
Okay, so that's kind of iffy because you don't always know the man until you actually have a kid by them.
Hello.
A man becomes a different type of man once you have that kid.
And a woman too.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Because I have two different baby daddies and they play different roles.
Mm-hmm.
And
baby.
So here I am about to play devil's advocate. When you are dealing with a man and you are past that 4-week, 90-day, whatever it is, you know exactly what you're dealing with.
Mm-hmm.
You see the red flags.
I beg to differ.
Yes, you
as a father,
I beg to differ.
Or as a partner.
I beg
so
to differ.
You know, yes.
As a
you
dad,
know.
A dad is partner. I think it's different.
So you know, you may not know 100%, but your intuition gives you a great deal of insight into what type of person or baby daddy or whatever.
Okay, we got
this man is gonna be mad day always comes, but you kind of got a good idea of what.
She's like, no, you know who the hell.
Well,
you
she said you know who he is. That green goblin
right
showed you his features.
Listen,
I just want to say right quick.
No, we got
to piggyback off of that. Mm-hmm. I feel like even like me not having kids, I always date guys with kids and I'm attracted more to the father he is than, you know, him with other things that we might discuss because my dad was absent.
I was going to say daddy issues.
Everybody
I was
around
thinking
me are, you know, single mothers.
For sure.
So one thing that I always say is I try to learn from the mistakes that happen around me. And I think that that is very important. Once you know who you are and the things that you're dealing with, you know what you want from the man that you're with, childless or not. But you have to know where you are and what it is that you're looking for in a man all around.
Okay.
Okay, we got another man.
We got a man in the building.
But all I'm hearing is being single with kids suck. You sound like you need to be married, huh? That's what it started to sound like to me. I'm just saying.
Well, I'm a father of two. My second child is also my wife and my partner. So, essentially, someone said that they're different. Or is it based off of who you pick or whatever? Every day I change. Not every day am I the same. as a father or as a guy that just in my industry, I change every single day. The morning, one day I can be all happy, and the evening I can be mad as hell. Next week I can be, hey, let's go on a trip, and then I can tell you, no, we're not going to that. So it's not always within a 30, 60, or 90-day period a person going to change. Every day a person change.
Yes.
And again, I'm a father, and I have two different baby mamas. But it is always a change daily, not momentarily, not monthly or weekly. You can't judge it because, oh, he looked good today, or she feel good today, or whatever. No, we change.
Yeah.
My mentality of a lot of things is going to always change, babe.
Yes.
It's always going to change.
We're always ever evolving.
You're
going to
evolve every day because you could teach me something today, and guess what? Now my viewpoint has changed because you taught me something in one point. One day, you taught me something. Now I got to look at it different, babe.
Yeah.
It's a teaching game. You treat it like college. Literally, you learn something every single day.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, all thank right. you for popping off. We got some socials.
We got the socials.
Are speaking. They are with the women, but they also with Cowboy John. They making you over here. But somebody said you don't know a man until you have a kid with him, live with him, marry him, and then you still may not know the real him. It's all everything changes. And yes. They agree with you, Mr. Cowboy, and they say hee haw. Also, they said men with multiple baby mamas and they don't take care of their children, they're completely diabolical, yeah. And it needs to be abolished. And to my sister in over here, they said sometimes it's better to not date men with kids, especially if they're not responsible.
Or even the man that takes care of some kids and not others.
I would like
that
something.
Part.
That ain't him.
Disgusting. So...
Okay.
And we see that all the time.
All right, guys. So we're going to move on.
I would like to add something.
I'm sorry.
I'm here.
Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Ooh, yes. Okay, Grace Jones, realness.
Okay.
Let's go. Pop off, boo.
I understand that it's fair. She's looking attention from the baby daddy, which is why, because she needs support. But at the same time, I think it's better for a single woman to raise their children, even they have different daddy, because the baby daddy can be toxic. And when it's toxic, it affects the kids.
Children. Mm-hmm.
And the fact that it affects the kids, when the kids growing up, they'll become the same as their baby daddy. Sometimes it's better to keep the baby daddy alone,
mm-hmm.
So the baby can grow up in a healthy community.
Pour into me right now.
Take out the toxic.
Yes.
Listen to you over there.
She's talking to me, y'all.
And I love your accent.
All right, y'all. So now we're going to move on to my girl, Taylor, because she's going to tell us what's hot off the swipes.
So while we're looking what's hot off the swipes, our baby daddy of the year with everybody else, Neo, he said,
wow.
You know, he wanted the infamous ones.
Wow.
He said he isn't putting on the cap of the amount of women that he's willing to make his girlfriends, as many as he can afford. What do y'all think?
Wait, what? I was too busy yapping about Neo.
Right. He says he is not putting a cap on the amount of women that he's willing to make his girlfriend, as many as he can afford.
Girl, we've been known he had community dick.
Nobody wants.
Can I say that?
I mean,
Neo out here running old house.
Can I say the D word? First of all, we already knew Neo like to spread it, take it low and spread it wide. We already knew that about Neo. That's not nothing brand new. We know you are a whore.
And they still gonna mess with him.
We know you like community.
But that brings to the greater question of what you think when men have multiple girlfriends. Because he's not only him. It's Nick Cannon. Dirt. It's Neo. The blue face, he made a whole damn show on it. So what do you think about...
Money make a move, don't it?
I ain't moving.
Money make a move, don't it? That's all I'm saying.
But what do you... Multiple girlfriends, it's literally my man is your man is her man, her that's
oh,
her
like,
man.
Even like
some girls like that, though.
They do. Because even the whole thing with Chief Keef and Sexy Red and what's his name's sister. I can't think of the rapper's sister.
Blueface's sister.
No. Blueface's sister ain't dating Chief Keef.
Oh, King Von's sister.
King Von's sister, right. They're all okay with having this sister wives thing. And polygamy, is that the word I'm looking for?
Yeah.
That's becoming a thing now. So people are being a little bit more accepted of,
and Polly.
Listen, we gotta share. We might as well share and care together.
So can I ask a question? Mm-mm. So if you can afford it, why not? Because they're gonna say, yeah. So if you can afford, isn't that what y'all want?
It's always been said that.
Isn't that what they want?
We've always said that, though. We've always said if you can't afford to have two households, you shouldn't be cheating. So if you can afford to have eight households, cheat away.
So that's all I'm saying. If you that's can what afford they're saying. It, makes sense, don't it?
Yeah. Get the mic.
I think it goes back to communication. Everything is based around communication. Because if he's being honest and saying, look, I don't want to wife you. I just want to, you know, then if you say, okay,
I want you to part of my collection.
Because if a woman is single, she want to date whoever she want to date. She got to keep it real with herself instead of trying to be the perfect Patty. And yeah. The dude ain't even trying to commit to her, but she giving him her all. Now, that's on her. So
and I, would
I
rather,
think that men do it because women allow them to do it. And now really, sometimes they say that that's what they want and they think it's cute. And maybe it is to them. I don't know. I mean, maybe they're not being honest.
I want to be a part of a classic collection, not a trash collection.
I think like the way the world is moving right now, like just with every aspect of life, social media, whatever, a lot of the things that men and women thought in the past that they would never, I would never. They're allowing because the trash to kind and goodness ratio is like, so now instead of like being single, because they don't want to be single or whatever, they're accepting things that they never in a million years would have thought that they'll accept.
True.
But it's like you either stand 10 toes down on what you believe in, or be by yourself.
Absolutely.
Or be with trash. So it's like crazy.
She
the values and morals
you.
Have
she
to stand
to
for something.
No, friend. Grandmas and aunties been doing it. They on that Betty Rice
back
shit.
In the day, right?
Oh, I'd rather have a piece of man than none at all. So it's been happening. It's just now the younger crowd be like, well, you can't beat them, join them. But they going to, you know, cook up a little food, have a little party, you know. Don't pay me the child.
I love it.
Come on, man.
We're good.
Any socials? We're good?
Somebody on the social says, not community D. And they also said, men only do women allow. I'm selfish. I'm not fond of sharing 3+. He should drive a minivan for that. I'm a 2-seater type of girl.
Oh, I think that's
great. Oh, 2-seater?
Period.
Whatever. Well, on that note, y'all, we got through the first episode of Let's Pop Off, y'all. I want all of you watching online out there, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube page, Supa Cindy, Supa Cindy. We're doing episodes of Let's Pop Off constantly, and make sure you follow us on IG at Let's Pop Off. I want to thank all of you for watching, all of you for being in the building. Shouts to PS Social, Project Hub, my co-host, Believe Productions, Opulent Events and Catering.
Shout out to Opulence, the Ceviches,
DJ Shorty Doo-Wop, and of course, JR Photo for all our pics. Thanks to everybody. We'll see you soon. Let's pop off, y'all.
Okay.